Okay, this room is really intimidating and all, but... Thank you.
Okay, we're gonna try this one more time and then we're done playing with you. Understand? Jelly, where are you from?
Jumbo Grain. Up and loose and heavy treat sandwich.
Jesus Christ, does anyone have any idea what this thing is saying?
Hotly, Derp arrange you.
Why are you here? What the hell do you want? Why'd you stow away on that ship?
School bearing boy. Eyes many cauterizing loops through and about. Wind and Windy Mitchell.
Did he just say Mitchell? Was there a Mitchell at NASA?
Tubes.
You know what? Never mind. I can't do this anymore. Just send this thing to the guys in research. Let them cut it up or whatever they do. You hear that? They're gonna cut you up, you pain in the ass.
Spider time.
like whatever force had a hold on Hartman isn't mixing well with the Hiss corruption. Wake did call him the third thing.
A chain letter. I remember these. Mom used to say they were evil. Better do what it says. You know, just in case. There must be a photocopier around here.
Okay. I'm just going to freestyle a bit. My mother always said, never talk to strangers. Always. Never. Never. Always. Never. Never. But isn't a stranger just someone you don't know? What if the only thing stopping a stranger from being a friend is that word? Stranger. Strange-er. Strange like the noises you hear at night when there is no light and you cannot fight. Strange like a rubber duck that follows you around and makes you drop your coffee every time that it quacks because the noise scares you. Then you have to clean up the coffee while the duck stares at you and continues to quack, 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 quack. Okay.
This is the director. I need backup at my location. collector.
Attack from the side!
This piece is called Me and You. It's summer in New York City. A boy with a wolf's head eats some ice cream. The ice cream melts. The wolf head howls. We howl together, me and you. The mayor stares at a bicycle. A little girl watches him watch the bike, watch him watch the bike, and on and on and on, like the ticking of 1,000 clocks. We listen to the ticking together, me and you. A traffic light decides it doesn't want to be a traffic light anymore. People call it names, and it's hurt. I take it to see a movie. We have a good time, me and you. People think we're weird, but we ignore them. We're friends now, connected by a moment. We'll always share this story, even if people don't understand it. You and me. Me and you.
This is Director Faden. Send a ranger to my position.
Thank you. doctor can feel the heartbeat.
There. One less place for him to hide.
Yes, B? Worry who? See the scene.
Hello?
Hello! Great about us today. Long roads and no hardly. You are Bygone?
Sure. Why are you locked up in here?
Casual turning. Back in front. And Gerbil took the top head. Not being pressed for that. Lady going and loosing back for I?
Sorry, I think I'm misunderstanding you. What do you want?
The head. The head for tails. For reading news, jars, words, and tumble. The reading head.
Okay. Take it easy. I'll take a look.
So, maybe it wants something to read. Or a jar. Let's just see what we can find.
Thank you.
be what it wants. Let's give it a shot.
No, jars. A head. Scotch and peppers? Head.
Okay, that wasn't right. Let's try something else. It'll like this.
Head. A. S. B. E. Head.
Nope. Let's keep trying. Was this what you had in mind? Maybe this will do the trick?
Bruce, you ping pong ahead!
Guess that wasn't it either. Huh. This might do it. Maybe.
Lady, you are school and dirt for losing.
Keep that up, and I won't help you anymore.
See if this will do it. I'm ready to be done with this.
Hurry, clocks, lady. The head.
Ed, no snacks. Head is top of all up and down. At the top. The top head.
Wait, does this thing actually mean head? Head is in a body's head? Where the hell am I gonna find that? And how did it lose it? Is that what the prisoner meant? I guess there's only one way to find out.
Chicken station. Far tastier. Press any button.
So the helmet is what you're after, huh?
Tubes. Snug and grape. Pure grapes. Hail a lady.
You're welcome, I guess. Did Kirkland lock you up in here?
Chief Trouble? Yes. Teddy's long around. But holdouts and happiest. Can gather for goldfishes. No wrinkle.
Okay. Well, sounds like you're doing fine in there now. Just make sure you don't go anywhere.
Jelly.
At least we helped this guy. I think. Best we leave it locked up, though. We have no idea what it is, and we don't need any more problems out here. Thank you.
just nice to have someone to talk to, you know? Ever since I got put in charge of the Panopticon, people treat me different, like I'm crazy for wanting to work with altered items. People just don't understand the altered items like I do, you know? I don't want to brag, but it does take a very empathetic mind to connect with the items.
Doesn't want to brag. Right.
People are making it so personal. I mean, the teams in research handle paranatural materials every day, and no one thinks they're weird. Well, maybe that's not true. Darling is famous for being a bit out there, but when he's weird, it's charming. Altered items really aren't that frightening once you get to know them. If you figure out what they like or don't like, you know, what sets them off, then there's nothing to worry about. I guess at the end of the day, we're still just wild animals scared of our own shadows. We're supposed to be on the same team, but sometimes it feels like it's every department for themselves, like it's a race and we're all trying to be number one. If it is a race, though, I'd say Darling is a mile ahead of everybody. He was Trench's golden boy for years, but that relationship has gotten pretty tense, or so I've heard through the grapevine. Not that I spread rumors, just, you know. People talk. Not me, though. I keep my nose to the grind. Too much work to do to focus on those kinds of things. I need to stay focused so I can get my work done and get home to feed Alfred.
He's
of course,
just gonna talk forever,
can't always make it home for mealtime, so I have my neighbor check in on Alfred at 7 o'clock if I'm not back yet. She's very nice. Her name is Maria. She's older. She came to New York in the 50s to attend school and has been here ever since. She has a couple of kids. I met them at Thanksgiving. Big family. Very nice people. Anyway, she has a key to my apartment, and she gives Alfred his dinner if I'm not home. I'm gonna have to buy her a nice fruit arrangement as a thank you after this. I'm missing a lot of Alfred's mealtimes. She's probably gonna have to go to the store for more wet food. I have to remember to pay her back. Hold on, let me make a note. Pay back Maria for Alfred's food. Okay. Oh, one more thing. And buy her a fruit arrangement. All right, done. Are you a cat person? I don't think I ever asked. You seem like one, though. You'd like Alfred. He's very proper. Really carries himself well, you know? I named him after my favorite poet. Felt like a good fit. I got Alfred just before Sylvia died when I was at the... You know, I don't really remember where I got Alfred from. But, boy, those two did not get along. Oh, no. Sylvia thought she owned the place. Didn't like me getting in her way. Scratched me more than once when I was just trying to move her food bowl. That cat was a real asshole.
Wow.
I'm realizing now that that language is entirely, professional. You see, Sylvia didn't tolerate most people, or animals, or anything. And that's what I meant when I said asshole. I would never use that word about a person. It was just, hey, there's a light flashing on the console here. I got to, check this out. I'll get back to you later.
Real smooth, Langston.
Sector when it was evacuated. Well, not there. I was in executive because they have the best snack machines. You may think they're all the same because of that plain white packaging, but there's a difference. You know those thick ruffled potato chips? They're my favorite. All the machines outside executive carry those flimsy little thin chips. They have no texture. I may as well eat cardboard.
Anyway, I get back to the elevator and they tell me the sector is
being evacuated. They wouldn't even let me go back in for my stuff. Can you believe that? I worked at that desk for years. I had photos on it. My favorite stapler, one of those good ones that could staple a 50-page report, no problem. A little cash and some, personal recordings. But, yeah, they lock the whole area down tight, no one in or out. And then they march us all back to executive to interview everyone. I wasn't even there when it happened, and they were asking me if I noticed anything suspicious, if I saw anyone tampering with the containment cell and so on. Well, the only thing they learned was I prefer the ruffled chips to the non-ruffled ones. Better mouthfeel, like I said before. And then, after 3 hours of questions, they recommend we all go for trauma counseling. I was like, no thanks, I have my own therapist. I know I could use the word therapist and save a few bucks, but I worry they're going to put anything I say in a file somewhere. A bit paranoid, I know, but I work for a secret government organization, so... yeah. I stopped going a few years back. To my therapist, I mean. She said that a lot of my issues stemmed from a negative outlook. Of course, I can't tell her anything about what I do, so I just had to sit there and nod. I kept waiting for that big aha moment. You know, where I realized that my need for approval stems from my dad or something? Turns out therapy doesn't work like that, so I stopped going. TV really gives you a skewed understanding of these kind of things. She did help me realize that I'm processing stress in an unhealthy way. I try not to carry all that around with me anymore, but it does stack up. Hard to just say no thank you to the anxiety buzzing in your head. One really helpful thing she had me do was find a creative outlet. I started doing some experimental music / poetry that I think was really ahead of its time. This was years back. I'm cooking up some pretty new sounds these days. Think My Bleeding Clock meets Sylvia Plath.
Do you play any instruments?
Well, I can see you being a guitarist, maybe a bassist. It's funny, I played the tuba in high school band. My favorite was In the Hall of the Mountain King. Tuba didn't get a lot of spotlight in most of the songs Mrs. McKinley chose, but Mountain King was my time to shine. Bum 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 bum. Ah, classic. I've moved on to less mainstream instruments now, but the tuba will always be a part of me. What were we talking about before? Right, the evacuation. Yeah, I heard afterward that the Hartman specimen had gotten loose and killed some staff. They had me digitizing records in some dark corner of the sector, so I didn't know a whole lot about the Bright Falls investigation at the time. It's a strange case. Most AWEs are one and done, but Bright Falls has pretty regular flare-ups. 3 incidents since 1970 when we first started tracking it. I got really interested when I heard Alan Wake was involved with the latest occurrence. I'm a huge Wake fan. I love the Alex Casey novels. That over-the-top, hard-boiled detective thing is right up my alley.
Wake.
They're making a movie of the series.
It can't
but the
be
guy
a coincidence
Casey
that I saw him in a motel.
Gravel in his voice, you know? I remember being
drawn here by the investigation.
Wake killed off Casey in the books. It's not a huge surprise, though. Wake sounded like a bit of a dick. Drank too much, fought paparazzi. The tabloids even said he was an abusive husband. So, yeah, troubled artist and all that. Apparently, there were chapters of an unfinished manuscript floating around after Wake disappeared. People say they're cursed, which is a very discriminatory term against altered materials, by the way. The forums all call the unfinished book Departure because Wake kept saying it would be a departure from his previous work. I found some pages that are supposedly the real deal on the internet. It's pretty dark stuff. He was going full horror, which makes sense since he used to write for Night Springs, but I would have preferred if he did something a little lighter. I've always said Wake had a great instinct for humor. Hey, did you know we own Night Springs? Yeah, the Bureau bought the rights after the original series ended. I've sent some story suggestions to the production team, but apparently they are not accepting pitches at this time. Typical. I'd be a great addition to their team, right? Huh. I didn't see you nod. Is this thing not on?
Oh, it's definitely on.
Okay. Oh, the wire's down here. Huh. Oh, looks like it should be working. Hello? If you can hear me, shoot something. That was inconclusive. You shoot so often, it's hard to know when it's intentional. There also could be a delay on this video feed. Maybe the system just needs a reboot. This is a good opportunity to use a restroom anyway. Stay safe, ma'am. You guys are going to escort me, right? Okay, good.
Thank you.
This is the director. I need backup at my location.
Reinforcements are here!
Thank you.
Christ! Did the Hartman thing do all this?
Reminder, the law of three also applies to all faucets within the oldest house. Be mindful and don't cause any aquatic misconduct. Thank you for your attention.
lots of dark corners to hide in. Okay, let's get the lights on and clear him out.
No!
Agent Guthrie, interrogation 4C, pertaining to the Eagle Limited incident and its subsequent, state alteration.
Look, buddy, I have no clue what you're talking about.
So you deny being a part of a radical group aiming to affect inanimate objects in a manner that would yield, unusual results?
Yeah, I deny. But hey, tell me more about these results. They sound real unusual.
I'm sure you recognize that the measures this group of yours takes to achieve their goals can be considered acts of terrorism.
Goals? Measures? You're being very vague. Did you know you're being very vague?
All right, 62 dead. Passengers and crew, innocent people. Still sound vague to you?
You might as well stop wasting both our time. I won't say anything, and you can't say anything. I know you can't.
Tell you what I can do. I can throw your sorry ass in one of our cozy containment cells. You can rot there until you're ready to talk. Or you could just save us both the trouble and tell me all about how you're going around creating altered items. How's that sound? Did you really think we wouldn't catch on to you? We always do. Always. So you might as well come clean. For your sake.
I think I'll just talk to my lawyer instead.
That's not how it works around here, buddy. But tell you what, why don't I leave you here to think on it for a while? See you in a couple of days.
Wait!
All aboard.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard the Eagle Limited bound for Chicago. Please have your tickets ready and enjoy the ride.
Good evening, all you fine-looking folks. Here's some smooth tunes to ease your minds and please your ears as we wait for that delicious dinner to roll right on in.
Stops Alton, Carlinville, and Springfield. That's Alton, Carlinville, and Springfield. Tickets, please. Tickets. Oh my God. Fire! Fire! Everyone, stay in your seat. In your seat. Nothing to sir. Sit down. Everyone, hold on.
That was chaotic. Felt like it was trying to tell me something. I wonder if I can make sense of it. Thank you.
Agent Go.